South Africa against Argentina. They've played 42 times, two-thirds South Africa have won, but Argentina did win last season in Hong Kong. So South Africa have been looking good. Three wins against Wales, Canada, Kenya, 15 tries. And remember, they winners the last tournament in Port Elizabeth and the Winners' Cup in Las Vegas last year and 3 years before that. Argentina, well, they were pretty fine yesterday over the wins over USA and Spain, but they lost to France today. But remember, experiment, nine new players in this season. They did come fourth in the final in Port Elizabeth, but in the Cup semi-final there against South Africa, they lost zip to 31. South Africa, without doubt, the most quickest team on the world at the moment, with tremendous strength too of the starting forwards, Chris Dry, Frankie Horn, Carl Brown, and outside all sprinters like Dupria, Senatla, Africa, and Gedult. Argentina, well, only one of experience in the start, that's Gaston Revol, with even captain on the bench, Nicolas Brazzoni, and also Diego Palma. So, interesting new selection by the new coach, the man who has always scored more tries than ever in the sevens, and that, of course, is the new coach, Santiago Gomez Cora, with 230 tries. Well, and of course, he won here in the USA sevens. That was in Los Angeles in 04 and San Diego 09. Big problem now, perhaps, for them, Gareth Rees, for Argentina against South Africa. They look so good at the moment.
Well, they do. Both past champions here in Vegas. And as they take the field, a huge crowd assembling here. What a backdrop for these players as Neil Diamond's Sweet Caroline rings around. And a great fixture here. And South Africa, definitely the form team for many here in Las Vegas.
Well, their record has been remarkable. They won Las Vegas, beat New Zealand in 13, and in 2011 as well, they were the cup finals when they beat Fiji that time. Referee, James McPhail. Well, he's from New Zealand, from Wellington, but now he's living in Netherlands.
We're all neon final here, South Africa in their traditional neon green, and yeah, Argentina in their orange.
I don't think they're very kind to have the numbers for the crowd here. There's Frankie Horn, 53 times tournaments in a row, absolutely extraordinary. And here, Cecil Africa, hasn't scored yet, it's extraordinary in a way. This guy has got 97 tries already. I thought he might get 100 here. So, key first cup quarter-final. Argentina with the orange colours. The way immediately by Hannibal Garrido. This time Franco Sabato. Picked up well by Sinatra. Has been
great going forward.
Five tries already.
He was fine first. He beat the ruck.
I think he beat you.
Green going forward, green scrum.
So you heard the referee. The Argentinian player had rights and was okay. But as it was stalled, we don't have the put in. South Africa to put in.
Square and steady.
Okay. There is.
Yep, here we are.
Spin. Hedult.
Crouch.
Taking over really from Delport, who's been
Bond.
Injured badly. Scrum half.
Sit!
He's doing pretty well himself. He's pedaled. Brilliant move, but the terrific tackle coming from Gaston Revol. Absolutely saved it. I thought it was going to be straight through. There goes Branko Dupria.
Turnover was fine.
Some tackle that was, wasn't it?
Well, that's what it is. That's exactly what Argentina are going to have to do. He sets the tone. Gaston Revol with a crushing tackle and then gets to his feet immediately and poaches the ball.
It's always been a strength, isn't it, of their attacking. Tremendous. Very good in defence.
On a back. Yep, on a back too.
I remember saw them in Los Angeles.
Come closer.
04 and San Diego in 09, and their tackling was away. Danger here. There's a tackle again, a good one, but the support is terrific. And there, the first try for Cecil Africa for Las Vegas 2014. There's number 98th try.
Well, Najee, you said he hasn't scored yet,
yes.
But when it matters, this man steps up, puts the team on his back in many ways, and always finds a spark. This time a looping run, and the defender's not able to get that wide.
Yeah, it was a good pass, wasn't it, from Sanatla?
Yeah, Africa works so well off the ball to get himself into good positions.
That's useful, isn't it? Oh, brilliant. From the man who scored the try, Cecil Africa.
Watch as he keeps working to the outside there. Good work. Africa very much the face of sevens rugby in many parts and a big part of the IRB's fair play, keeping rugby clean, the anti-doping campaign. So he's a great ambassador for sevens rugby.
Well, they got 91 points in the first three pool games. Did South Africa.
More.
Impressive.
Argentina
there by
danger.
Chris Dry.
Dry night. Yeah, it's the tactic South Africa uses, as do the Kenyans, really getting under that ball.
Yeah, those two guys really do a lot of good work, really. Kyle Brown does tremendous, like Chris Dry as well. There's Gaston Rivol. He's the only really experienced at the start at the moment. This is his 30th tournament.
Cinco. Okay. Crouch.
Kiddled.
Come closer. Yep, here we are. Come closer.
Started
Crouch.
Playing in the sevens in Wellington last
Bynes.
Season.
Sit.
Coming back here.
Oh. That's a slip there,
come
Nigel.
Closer and on the back. On the back.
Yeah, just lost his footing.
Here hasn't been much problem, really, for the turf, has it? I must say here. It has been in the past, but not this time.
This is a field, a grass field, that's laid on top of the turf here.
Sit.
Sam Boyd Stadium, and it's held up really well.
It really has. Fedul Glenn gets
green.
It away.
Offside.
Well taken.
Advantage over.
And the pace, look at the pace. And there you go. Well, I guess, I don't know whether he's Carl and Niles as quick, but he's pretty close, isn't he? Ciabello Senatla, and that's sixth try for him.
Well, he's definitely direct off that left foot. Yeah, and the defender slipping by, too much ground for him to cover. The leg lift, more than enough pace to get in.
This is first game in this season, played four. Five rather last season. I missed that Gold Coast, Dubai, and PE, but here he is and making a mark. My goodness me, 12-0.
It is one of the challenges for the opposition in South Africa. If you mark a Cecil Africa and take him out, or a Pranko Dupria, you know the others are free. And Sanatla just proved he's a world class finisher. And
they've got the option though, haven't they? I mean, they've got so much pace than any other team, without doubt. I mean, when you've got Maastricht behind and Werner Kock and Speckman, apparently, the new guy. Good work by Argentina here. Knock on, advantage played into the hands of Anibal Garrido. Brothers on the bench. Facundo. Two of them, brothers.
Well, how Mr. McPhail has deemed that advantage.
Yeah, okay.
We see the players asking him. They're immediately tied up and lose possession. So, an interesting call there, to say the least.
There's
here
Frankie.
We are. Let's go.
Frankie Horn, first played in 2007. Never missed one tournament. It's remarkable, isn't it? The only thing, sadly, he missed was the last Rugby World in Moscow.
Six.
Last year.
Hold, Tim.
Pedal. Well picked up. Good work by Augusto Salas, one of the new players. This is his first tournament. picked up by Joaquin Paz. Away by Gaston Ribol.
A little bit lateral right now, the Argentinian attack.
Yeah, you're right. Augusto Salas.
Punishment.
Who to Sams. 12-0. It's a penalty, though. On the, off the wrong side. South Africa quickly taken. They're often very, very quick. Once again, Joaquin Paz. Sanatla, is he going to get caught? Salas goes, but he can't get him. And so the try then by Branko de Pria. Good work, of course, set up by Ciabello Sanatla. Gets away.
Well, desperation tackles from the Argentinians.
Good pass.
Good awareness to flip it inside. De Pria, again, working hard in support lines.
That's his fourth as well.
Bit of a friendly nudge there as he thought about running it under the post. Well, very much to form, Nigel, I think.
Yeah, I think so. Particularly seeing Argentina losing to France today in 0-14.
Yeah.
And the conversion is good, so it's going to be 19-0 by South Africa. Looking good still. 19-0 against Argentina. Elusive, wonderfully elusive, wasn't he?
I just wonder, commenting on their attack, do they need a dose of Santos Comas-Cora, someone to unlock the South African defence?
Yeah, I mean, he's experimenting, you know. I mean, he's had so many players this season.
Good scenes here. You see the cheerleaders finishing up. The team talks are done.
And a great crowd too, hasn't it been, for the second day? You know, it's not the finals today. This is just to the finals of the Cup quarterfinals. This is the first one. Three to come, of course. So, Argentina.
Oh.
No pale blue anymore. What would you call that colour? Coral?
Coral, there you go. Salmon.
Would that do right?
Salmon.
Okay. Salmon, okay. That's the same. Switch by Gaston Ribol. There's who plays up in Argentina. Cordoba. Very strong. Rugby game in that part. In touch.
Well, unlucky, great decision, unlucky bounce as the pressure from the South African defence pushed it behind with the boot. Good awareness from Revol, but it just went into touch.
Very experienced player, since 30th time as 27-year-old now, and one of the five players who are in the Rugby World Cup sevens. No number, by the way, at the air for Joaquin Paz. Again, Carl Brown. Neatly done. Heddled. Switch again. Look at the pace. Good race, though, by Sabato. He's done well. Very well indeed, I must say.
There's a chance if the Argentinians can get it away, or when they can't. Looks like Sanatla may be down.
Yeah, it is, I think. Is he okay?
So pressure comes in here. Tries to stop on the ball. Two Argentinians.
Yeah, he missed the kick, didn't he?
Oh, yeah, just buckled his knee under himself there.
But he was under real pressure there, and I think Franco Sabato really saved him.
Yeah, a lot of pain there, and that would be a big loss.
This guy has been outstanding, and of course his first time in this season of the HSBC Sevens. That's a big blow for them, although there are some guys with the pace as well who are not starting. Sampi Mastriet, I guess.
As we see him hobble off the field, Nigel, It's worth mentioning the last time these two teams met was in South Africa, in Port Elizabeth, and that famous run the South African team had to the final to win just days after Mr. Mandela had passed away. And
yeah, it was remarkable, wasn't it? And unfortunately, Argentina met them in the cup semi-final, and it was 31-0.
Yeah, I don't think anyone's going to beat them that week.
Well, you never know.
No advantage offside.
Good work again by Chris Dry. Into the hands his mate Kyle Brown, the captain. Must be a try, and it is for Chris Dry. Well, there's the forwards doing it themselves, and that for Chris Dry, his first in this tournament, but his 55th altogether in his 26th tournament.
Yeah, good awareness. You saw Brown eyes up, seeing where the options were. 4 meters out, not going to be stopped.
He wasn't going to pass it, was he?
Chris Dry, another one of those role players. You know, he allows the other runners around to...
I think he's been outstanding, this guy. I think he's been a key player for the last, 3 years? Chris Dry in the forwards, along with Frankie Horn and Kyle Brown as well. Very, very effective forwards. That's absolutely crucial. It's okay, you can have the fastest players in the game, but you've got to get the ball. And these guys have done it so well.
Ooh.
That doesn't look to help for him, does it?
Well, maybe it was his ankle getting caught to chase that ball. But
tried to flick it, didn't he? But it didn't work. So it's 24-0, four tries already. Well, I said it was an experiment, really, with Santiago Gomez Coro, the coach, with these players. He's looking for new players. He's telling me that and saying, well, I'm trying them out, and gone from 12 already in the fourth tournament over this season. Carl Brown looks uncomfortable.
Number 10, Green, sub.
Good captain he's been. Disappointment for him, of course, in the Rugby World Cup in the Moscow.
As soon as it hits the ground, it
suspended for a while. Made remarkable as a captain as in the UCT, in the University of Cape Town.
No one has to release for
that was where he made his name.
A few decent players come out of that program.
Oh, indeed.
Over the years.
Yeah.
And of course, all these South African players are centrally contracted and
full-time.
There.
Full-time.
Crouch.
So, Justin Hiddelt, one of the three players who played in the junior 15s under the 20s in Nantes, in France, last season.
Pushing over the mark.
What did James Maffeil see? He was offside.
Pushing early, I think, in the scrum.
It was a push, wasn't it?
Yeah. So South Africans will take their time.
Chris Dry then. Hiddelt.
Look at Dryden at the bottom of your screen.
Franco de Pria knocked forward. A chance here, perhaps, for the ball at least to get for Argentina. They have it. Just less than 3 minutes to go. Set up there by Salas. Been quite useful, this 20-year-old from Tucumán, one of the new debuts.
Yeah, Tucumán, not the traditional home of fluid sevens rugby, but
true enough. And here, worked now by
Spanish Green. Advantage over.
Lost there by Lucas Maguire. Carl Brown. Well, no problem at all there. Well, that Werner Kock, he's quick too, isn't he? A young guy, just 20-year-old. He was spotted in the Craven Week by Paul True. Nice pass.
Well, the result like this at 29-0, it also allows for Neil Powell to rest some of his big names. Cecil Africa has been substituted off at the end of day two here, getting a bit of extra rest, and allows the subs to get in there. Werner Kock on that occasion.
So comfortably now, 31-0, which was exactly the time they last met in Port Elizabeth in the Cup semi-final. South Africa won 30-1. 31 here. It is in the Cup quarter-final.
Come on.
Just over a minute to go.
Well, this win, Nigel, for South Africa, which is a crossover with the winner of Samoa in Australia. Fascinating stuff. Samoans, of course, with a huge support here.
Yeah.
In Vegas. And Australia have been beat Fiji yesterday.
Have
been a very, very difficult team to get past with a really resolute defence and an emerging star, I think.
They've looked tremendous from the start, I must say.
Time on.
Beat Wales 43-0. Your team, Canada, 29-0. Then Kenya, that wasn't so good, but 19-7 this morning. But they're learning, the Pumas here.
Rare possession for the Argentinians. And let's see if this substitute here, Lucas Maguire, can get his hands on the ball. Some very, very good reports coming out that he's very special and a great stepper.
High tackle.
From Chris Dry. Held on by Facundo Garrido. That's the other one. Then Salas again. Quite impressed, I thought. A nice break here and the chance for Argentina. Oh, the pass. And a gift, really. It's going to be, isn't it? Going to Roscoe Speckman, the new guy. Tackled, though, by Agustin Cortez. Speckman. Surely it must be. Well, Chris Dry, another one. He'll be really pleased about that. Impressive then, and they looked, I must say, all three games and this one since the start.
Well, they're very disciplined, the South Africans, and a good side right throughout the team. And one of the features of the discipline is they don't get tied up in contact. They get those hands free, even off the ground, keep the ball alive, not selfishly taking into contact, and they find the open man on too many times for the Argentines. It's been Chris Dry open on the end there all by himself.
And I'll tell you what, they look a very fit time in these games. Ooh. So, 6 tries, 36-0. South Africa get into the Cup semi-final, impressively, against Argentina.
Thanks for your help, guys. Jolly good.